Good evening. I'm Martha Rabbit. Tonight we follow the trials and tribulations of a legend, and how fame has forever altered her life. It was 3 years ago that we were first introduced to Rana Catesbiana, when she auditioned on FBC's The Noise. After winning a huge recording contract and producing 3 hit singles and a platinum record, Rana Catesbiana fell out of the public light. In her first interview since, Rana Catesbiana has come to set the record straight. Hello.
Howdy.
Good evening, Martha. You look ravishing.
Thank you, Rana Catesbiana. How are you?
Fantastic, but please, I have reinvented myself. I am now American Bullfrog.
I see. The public hasn't heard from you in quite some time. What would you say triggered your self-transformation?
I'm tired of bouncing between taxonomic terms. People would come up to me and say, Miss Catesbiana, is it Rana or Lithobates? You see, it's both. Traditionally, I'm from the Ranaday family, but I'm just as much Lithobates. Some have been so wild to call me Aquarana Catesbiana. That's ridiculous. I'm from the class Amphibia, and that's all that really matters, so I've decided to be American Bullfrog. For simplicity.
You sounded a little frustrated when you mentioned people approaching you because of your televised success. Was this part of the reason you've gone underground?
Partly. After my first album, Teacup-Sized Menace, I couldn't take the pressure. I started using again. I just wasn't in the place to make art. But I am a new frog now, and I'm ready to reintroduce myself.
Does that mean we can expect new music from you soon?
Yes. In fact, I've brought something with me today I'd like to show you now, if you could play it.
Is this the bullfrog? Is it amphibian? Caught in a mudslide? No escape from reality. Open your eyes, measure to pan eye and see. If it's a frog, boy, it's got big timpani. frog on a